This was a multifaceted campaign.
Our nation has no policy and thus no strategy for cyber deterrence.
In the first public hearing about Russia's interference in the U.S. election,
top intelligence officials said there is no evidence Moscow changed vote tallies, but said it's impossible to gauge the exact impact of the unprecedented cyber campaign.
The hacking was only one part of it, and it also entailed classical propaganda, disinformation, fake news.
You say you think this was approved at the highest level of government in Russia?
That's what we said.
While senators and intelligence officials talked about how the U.S. should define, defend, and retaliate against acts of cyber warfare at the international level, a cybersecurity task force co-chaired by Republican Congressman Michael McCaul released its recommendations for President-elect Trump's administration.
So I propose a major reorganization and consolidation of our domestic civilian cyber defense efforts into a single strong cybersecurity agency at the Department of Homeland Security.
The task force highlighted the need to quickly strengthen cyber defenses of America's critical infrastructure and recruit a new workforce in cybersecurity professionals.
Even if we wanted to make our government more secure and our IoT devices more secure, we can't find the people to do it.
All of this took place following tweets by President-elect Donald Trump casting doubt on U.S. intelligence agencies and their information about Russia's hacking, saying, Julian Assange said a 14-year-old could have hacked Podesta. Why was DNC so careless? Also said Russians did not give him the info. The Wall Street Journal reports that Trump is planning to revamp the intelligence community. And Thursday, he named recently retired Indiana Senator Dan Coats as his pick for Director of National Intelligence.